I, Nilima Salvi, working as assistant professor in Department of Pharmaceutics, Smriti College of Pharmaceutical Education, Indore. Today we are going to start with the additives or excipients which are used into the manufacturing of tablets. In previous video we discussed about the ideal characteristic of properties of the diamonds and which are the parameter which we on which basis we select the diamond for the manufacturing of tablets. So today we are going to start with the commonly used diamonds which are used in manufacturing of tablets. Diamonds are those substances which are generally used to increase the bulk of the formulation and they possess no therapeutic response onto the body. They only used or they are used as filler into the formulation. So after that, start with the commonly used diamonds. So which are the commonly used diamonds? That is, first is sugar. So sugar, in this category of sugar, generally dextrose, lactose, sucrose, mannitol and sorbitol are used as sugar based diamonds, in which the advantage of sugar based diamond are those generally they are used for the manufacturing of chewable tablets. This is because of that in chewable tablets we need a sweet type of diamond or which mask or cover the taste of API. So for that purpose we commonly used diamond is mannitol for chewable tablets. After that, these are sugar based diamonds. Then we use polysaccharides as a diamonds. In polysaccharide, commonly used starch and modified starch are used as a diamond. Then third category is cellulose. In cellulose, microcrystalline cellulose is commonly used as diamond, and microcrystalline cellulose is also known as MCC, and it is the cellulose type of cellulose derivative which is used as diamond. Then the next is inorganic compounds. So in inorganic compounds, the first of all calcium phosphate dihydrate, calcium lactate trihydrate and magnesium carbonate. So these are the different examples of inorganic compounds which are used as diamonds. After that, miscellaneous compounds are there which act as diamond into the tablet formulation. So in that, bentonite, polyvinyl pyrrolidone and silicon are used. So after that, this is the common classification for the diamonds. So or we can say these are the different categories which act as diamond in manufacturing of tablets. After the selection criteria or ideal characteristic of the diamond, we choose diamond for the manufacturing of tablet. After that, now we will discuss in detail one by one diamond or in which grade or under which commercial name they are available into the market. So start with the first of all, lactose. Lactose is widely or commonly used as a diamond, or it is the most widely used diamond into the tablet manufacturing. Then lactose, it is commercially available or it is available into two forms, that is hydrous and anhydrous. Hydrous form is generally used into the weight granulation process. There are different or three methods of tablet manufacturing. First of all, wet granulation technique, second dry granulation technique and third is direct compression. So these three are basic tablet manufacturing techniques. In wet granulation, what we do is that we combine or blend all the raw materials which are dry in form. So we mix all the dry powder into the formula and we bind that dry mixture blend with the help of any solvent or any vehicle. After that, we make granules of that mass. So it is known as weight granulation process. And second thing is dry granulation process. In dry granulation process, what happens on the place of solvent or vehicle, we use organic type of solvent or volatile solvent. So in that case, we use alcohol or chloroform as a solvent. So after some time, the solvent get evaporate and it doesn't weight the contain. So it is known as dry granulation technique. And third is direct compression technique. So in direct compression, what we do, we combine all the content together and we compress the content as a tablet. In that case, we use directly compressible diamonds, for example MCL, that is microcrystalline cellulose. So in that, we directly compress the tablets. So there are three categories or three methods of tablet formulation: brain granulation, dry granulation, direct compression. Then the lactose is, or hydrous form of lactose is used into the weight granulation process. Second is anhydrous form. Anhydrous form having advantage over the hydrous form, that is it doesn't undergo Maillard reaction. This is important, Maillard reaction. This is GPAT question, so you can mark it, that which tablet gives Maillard reaction. So anhydrous jo hote hain lactose, anhydrous type of lactose doesn't undergo Maillard reaction. What is Maillard reaction? So Maillard reaction is that when the substance or the content leads to browning or discoloration with certain drugs. Or you can say that hydrous type of lactose along with the certain drug or content get discolored, or it leads sometime browning of the tablet. So it is known as Maillard reaction. So anhydrous form doesn't undergo Maillard reaction and hydrous gives Maillard reaction. So after that, anhydrous form of lactose absorbs moisture when exposed to higher humid conditions. So when we will expose the anhydrous form of lactose into higher or increased humid condition, it start to absorb the moisture from the content. So it is, or because of this reason, this doesn't undergo for Maillard reaction. After that, there are two grades are available. So in this whole additive or category of diamonds, you have to remember that which grades or in under which name the content is commercially available. So this is important and this is important for your GPAT exam purpose. So there are two grades are available of lactose in market, that is 60 to 80 and 80 to 100. So 60 to 80 is the size which is known as coarse, and 80 to 100 which is known as regular grade. So there are two grades available of lactose. After that, the lactose give good release rate profile. It means what? When we are talking about the tablet, the API has to be released from the tablet for its action. Until unless the API doesn't release from the tablet, it doesn't produce therapeutic response onto the body. So the release rate of API from the tablet is important. So lactose give good release rate profile and it is of low cost, or you can say it is cheap, or it is easily available into the market. Then discolor in presence of amine drugs or salt of alkaline compound can be produced. It means in presence of amine drugs or salt of alkaline compound, the color or discoloration of the tablet could be occur. So we should not use the lactose along with the amine drug or salt of alkalines. So this was one more point in lactose, is that disintegration time are not strongly sensitive to variation in tablet hardness. It means the disintegration time, in how much time the tablet get disintegrate and dissolve into the body. So disintegration time doesn't vary the tablet's hardness because of the lactose. So this was the lactose, or you can say first your diamond. Second diamond is the spray dried lactose. So in this spray dried lactose, what happens that it is used for direct compression technique. Lactose is used in anhydrous form. We can go for wet granulation, and for with this anhydrous form we can go for the dry granulation. Spray dried lactose is for direct compression of tablet. Add disintegrating agent, drug and lubricant. Or you can say in this formula you can add disintegrating agent, APR and lubricant along with the diamond, and you can compress the content as a tablet. So this is known as directly compressible tablet. After that, spray dried lactose, it is dry and you can say moisture level falls below 3%. It means it in nature it is almost dry. Then it has good flow characteristic. It can be combined with as much as 20-25% of the APR. It could be combined with the 20-25% of the your active drug. Then it is prone to darkening in presence of excess moisture. If as we told or we talked that it is dried in nature, when it comes into the contact of moisture, it starts to darkening, or again we can say it could be discolor, or the final product could be discolor because of the moisture. So darkening in presence of excess moisture and amines could be there. Then neutral or acidic lubricant should be used for this. Or if we are using spray dried lactose as a diluent for the tablet, then we should only use neutral or acidic lubricant. We should not go for the alkaline type of lubricants. So this was a spray dried lactose and lactose. In next video we will discuss about the further diluents. Thank you.